Welcome to Headline News 24/7. Please click like and subscribe. Teen blindsided by what unexpectedly showed up at her house after Trump saw what she did. A smart young teenager was just doing something nice one day and had no idea it would turn out like this. The girl, 16-year-old Megan O'Grady, wanted to show her support for the police officers who passed away in the line of duty. This all seems to have come about after 5 officers were lost in Dallas during that horrific July in 2016. It was Megan who began a nonprofit called the Blue Line Bears, and what she does is something so spectacular and amazing that even President Trump took notice. Her project takes the uniforms of fallen officers and creates teddy bears out of them. Those can be sent to family members, friends, etc. It's a way to remember the brave officers who lost their lives while fighting for their community to stay safe. It's just one more way that the general public can show their love and respect for the people who strap on the boots and uniform every day and walk into the world of the unknown. Megan's father is also part of the police force and works as a sergeant, so one can easily tell how much this means to her. While she might receive accolades from her peers, it was something else that took her totally by surprise. It was a letter from President Trump that was sent to her. Imagine being a teenager just out in the world doing something good and the president acknowledges it. Some teens just want the people on their block to notice, but for the president to see it? Now that's amazing. President Donald Trump commended the teenager who started a nonprofit that uses the uniforms of fallen police officers to create teddy bears. Megan O'Grady, who started Blue Line Bears, said her organization's goal is a way to pay respect to those who have died in the line of duty. The 16-year-old, whose father is a police sergeant, said she got the idea to make teddy bears after 5 police officers were shot and killed in Dallas in July 2016. Trump said in his letter to O'Grady that he appreciates her efforts, and that her work helps fulfill the country's promise that the sacrifice of police officers will never be forgotten. O'Grady said Trump's letter to her shows that he is trying to change the country's attitude when it comes to law enforcement. "It made me really happy, and it's probably going to change my life," she said Saturday on Fox and Friends. O'Grady added that she feels safer now with Trump in the White House. "I have a voice now because of him. He speaks for all of us. He stands up for what we don't want to say openly because we're afraid to say it," she said. She said she plans on placing the framed letter from the president near her bed. "So I could wake up and be like, that's me," she said. President Trump is trying to reverse the rhetoric and make the country safer for police. American police officers faced hateful rhetoric from the public while Barack Obama was president. It seemed like Obama didn't respect the officers or the heroin work they do, so some members of the leftist-leaning affiliations took notice and acted the same way. It was a rough 8 years for police as they endured the rigor of the job while also facing the spiteful commentary and actions of the public who appeared to be vengeful towards police, even those who had done nothing wrong. Trump would like the American people to respect the laws and law enforcement. "Everyone should follow the laws and respect each other as citizens. It's a shame that some people still feel the need to treat the police with such disrespectful attitudes, and then they wonder why the police often react the way they do. Imagine being a police officer who responds to a shooting and then has bullets flying past their ears. It must be insanity. Police officers just want to go to work and then go home like everyone else. They don't want to do things that would make them have to sit around and do paperwork. The police are people too, and there's just so many people out there who need to remember that and respect the officers and their job. It's time for Americans to focus on the good police and show them the support they deserve."
That was the news. We thought you might be interested in knowing about this. Please click like and subscribe. Thank you.